counseling psychologist. I practice CBT, cognitive behavior therapy, rational emotive behavior therapy, and currently I'm learning this therapy called animal assisted therapy. All right, and today the topic of discussion is dealing with depression. So when we say depression, what all words or what all thoughts that you can come up with?
Sad, morose.
Okay.
Dull, inactive.
Constant deep thinking.
Okay. Is it basically when we say depression, you know, is it anything positive comes into the picture or the negative side?
Negative part?
Confusion. Confusion, maybe decision making mein problem ho jati hai, concentration khatam ho jata hai, attention khatam ho jata hai, memory loss hota hai,
possibility, forgetfulness,
because we are constant, the way he said, we are constantly thinking about those deep thoughts, like, you know, maybe what will happen next or, you know, some other ways. When we say depression, even WHO, the World Health Organization, has almost declared that by 2020, there will be depression will be the second disease, killer disease in the world. So you will see a lot of people, you know, we will see a lot of people coming to us for, you know, treatment of depression. So we'll see what is the next. What do you think about Jia Khan, Marilyn Monroe, Silk Smita and Robin Williams? What exactly they did?
Like
committed suicide. So the main,
obviously not happy with their life.
Yes, correct. Because of the all four of them are into acting field. You see that? Because they wanted the limelight. When with Jia Khan, I guess she was not getting the limelight for since like 3-4 years. Yeah, and she was not able to get proper work. So she got depressed because she was not getting proper work and she was not satisfied with the work that she was getting. So that's the reason made her depressed, and you know, she tried committing suicide. There were other reasons as well. Marilyn Monroe and Silk Smita, Robin Williams, he was under depression. He was taking drug therapy as well. And later on, I think he was 63 years old when he committed suicide. Every one of these, like I don't know about Marilyn Monroe and Silk Smita, but every one of the other two were undergoing depression treatment.
Drug overdose.
Yeah, correct. She took pills and, you know, she killed herself. They gave up on life because they thought now this is the end of the world and nothing is working for them. You know, that was the last thought that they thought. They might have tried a lot of things in their life, like trying to talk to someone or might be telling someone that this is happening, but that didn't work out. They were looking out for some other stuff or other things also to come into picture and, you know, needing help, but things were not working out for them. So that was the last option that they thought, and they killed themselves.
Why treatment,
it depends on a lot of stuff. Like, you know, you need to have, if you're diagnosed with depression, then there is medicines as well as you need psychotherapy, that is counseling. If both go hand in hand, if you are dropping out of some things, then, you know, the relapse rate is really high. So if you stop with medicines, see, what depression is basically brain chemical imbalances, you know, so to make that imbalances proper, you need medicines. Okay, and to change your thinking as well as your daily schedule, you need counseling and psychotherapy. All right, so if one of the thing has stopped, then, you know, they might be like, the treatment doesn't work because they might have stopped the medicines, because the way, you know, they'll be like, arre mujhe to abhi achha lag raha hai. So, you know, I don't need medicines. But whenever you take medicines, there is a proper course that you need to see. Without doctor's prescription, you can't stop the medicines. If you stop it, then the relapse rate is really high. You will feel happy for that some moment, like for 2 weeks or 3 weeks. Again, those sad feelings will come into picture. So there is, when you take medicines or when you take depression treatment, it has to be there that you have to complete the treatment. You have to complete it. Until and unless you complete it, that is the reason that if treatment is not working, they get into this, okay, fine. This is also the suicide thing. This is also called as a copycat syndrome. You know, they might look at some picture or like Three Idiots for that matter.
Media is also...
Yes.
Yes.
In Mumbai itself, there are a lot of people every day.
Just like encouraging this humility.
Yes. Even for that matter, it also happens because he, you know, he tried all possible stuff and he couldn't do it. So let me also give it a try. So that is also.
Just for another thing.
Yes.
As antidepressant. See, normal, most of the time this antidepressant class they come from, so whatever it is, are given. There is a certain thing that the very drugs which are given for overcoming depression is the cause of suicide itself. Because there are three elements.
Correct.
There is a drug-enhancing effect, there is a mood-elevating effect, and there is drive announcing is there, mood elevating is there, and depressed person, this anti-depressant effect, the drugs are taking some time to act.
Correct.
If the drive announcing effect comes before the mood elevating effect, then the very depression which was preventing.
Correct. Even antidepressants, because the medicines, you know.
The endemic could be the cause.
Correct. It might be. Possibility.
Because, see, the antidepressant effect is going to take some time. It takes about 4 to 6 weeks.
Correct.
For the antidepressant drug or the effect of the drug to be
It also depends in what quantity the doctor doctor is prescribing, because that also has the effect, like you know what level the depression is, like the milder one, a moderate or the severe. You know, depression is divided into different categories as well, so as per psychiatrist, as per his knowledge, he'll give accordingly the quantity, the doses of it. Correct.
But if the patient is having strong suicidal tendencies, it is very necessary for the patient to undergo the electroconvulsive therapy.
Yes, very much. Acute depression is, it is told that you need to have ECT treatments. And when there is a suicidal ideation, that is like the suicidal thoughts or suicidal actions, they might be like, you know, someone might cut his hand, or you know, someone might take drug overdose like Marilyn Monroe. It is necessary and mandatory that the person has to undergo like a pharmacotherapy treatment. He has to take medicines and counseling both together. Because I had this client, like 12-year-old child, who actually tried doing that. I had to first, you know, make her educate her and her mother that we need to start medicines with you. Until and unless, we won't be able to see any changes. Because a lot of behavior changes, a lot of behavior tantrums, because she was 12, the developmental, the puberty age was starting, it was all difficult for her to deal with her situations as well. So we had to start medicines as well as, counseling. Both also had to be started.
The first 6 weeks or so, one needs to be very careful.
Yes.
Because the anxiolytic effect and the mood elevating effect.
Correct.
They could take time.
Time to settle down, correct.
Drive enhancing effect is immediate.
Correct.
And the very depression which is preventing the person from enacting that thought of his committing suicide. Patient might be... will commit suicide because the drug has
an impact. Correct. We also need to see that, you know, if the person is like medicines also has those thoughts. So we need to see the ECT treatment or the, you know, the dosage and the quantity of the medicines also we need to increase or decrease. It depends on the, you know, post-medicine, what exactly are the symptoms.
Somebody should be there in the family.
Yes. Correct.
Somebody not there, so 24 hours observation is necessary.
Yes.
What when I feel.
Yes, yes, very much, very much. See, the family support system has to be there when there is a person who is depressed in the family. So what happens whenever the client or the patient comes in with the to the doctor, there is an informant or the family member with the person. Because you might know the client will give you a different history, the family might give you a proper history, what exactly is that person going. So whenever we take a case history or like the intake information, we have to have the person, the client, the patient, as well as the support system. So that if the client, the patient is not able to do certain tasks, we can tell the family to, you know, help the person out to, help the person out in dealing with that situation. It depends on the cases. It depends on, you know, what kind of depression and is it severe, you know, what exactly are the symptoms. Maybe first you show the physician. If he's not able to do it, then, you know, you can go directly. If there are suicidal symptoms and ideations and actions, definitely a psychiatrist has to be taken place. You know, psychiatrist is in the picture. Okay, so what is depression? It means a mood or a state. Mood would be a feeling. A state would be, you know, you stay in that period or you stay in that mode of sadness, pessimistic ideation with loss of interest or pleasure in normally enjoyable activities. Like you might be doing daily activities like getting up in the morning, going for a walk, you know, doing your breakfast. Depressed people... Yes, daily routine works. Depressed people might get up late, might sleep late, might get up late. They won't get out of the bed because they are feeling sad and because they're feeling that, you know, abhi kuch karne ke liye hai hi nahi, kya karu? Yeah, that is one reason. Accompanied by consequent weight loss or weight gain. You know, they might eat more or they might not eat. Feelings of worthlessness, as in, you know, they were doing certain activities and they label themselves as failure or something. Because of it, they are feeling worthless, that they cannot do anything right. And diminished ability to think or concentrate, the way we discussed, like concentration, attention kam ho jata hai. Everyone feels low from time to time, which is actually pretty normal. For some people, low mood persists for weeks, months and years with for some people, low mood persists for weeks, months and years with very little relief. We'll have to check the low mood. Like, is it remaining for the day, for 2-3 days continuously, for week or for weeks? Or, you know, we'll have to check. You know, if that is happening, then there is a sign of depression. You know, you might be feeling depressed about, you know, a single, what you can say, the start of depression. Like, you know, a single event that might have happened at that point of time. And, you know, you continuously think about it. You know, the way he said, you know, continuously you go into that deeper thought and continuously think about it. A lot of time, people make themselves depressed. What we call it as rumination. The way I was discussing with Anju ma'am, ki, you know, bahut logo ko dukhi rehna bahut zyada pasand hai. Because sympathy milti hai. Abhi humne baat ki thi. You know, bahut zyada sympathy mil jati hai ki haan, log mere taraf dekhte hai, mere baare mein sochte hai. Agar main isse nikal jati hu, to mujhe koi dekhega bhi nahi. You know, so the willingness of coming out of that depression is zero because they don't want to take it. She, as what she said, you know, she wanted, she was taking medicines, but she dropped the medicines because she was feeling good. And then what exactly happened? The relapse happened. Because if you suddenly stop the medicines, the relapse would happen. Again, those people around you will be like, you might have come across many family members or something. Some people you know at least in your life. Yeah, ye log aisa karte hain aur sympathy gain karne ki koshish karte hain. Signs and symptoms of depression. Prolonged depressed mood. Thoughts of hopelessness. Because they are not hopeful at all. Hopeful about what are they doing during the schedule, the daily routine, what are they doing. It might differ from person to person. It might differ for a kid, for a child, for an adult, as well as for a middle-aged or a married person. You know, it might differ those hopelessness feeling and it will be different. Change in appetite. They might eat properly on time or they might eat a lot. Change in sleep patterns. Generally, depressed people sleep a lot. They feel a lot of, tired and fatigue. They are not energetic. लथार्जिक कुछ भी करने जाओ तो सारी लथार्जी आ जाती है, बिकॉज इतना सोचते हैं कि उसमें ही सारी एनर्जी चली जाती है, उसकी वजह से वो कुछ काम कर नहीं पाते. एंड दैट इज़ द रीज़न दे हैव डिफिकल्टी इन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, मेमोरी एंड अटेंशन. That is the reason they are not able to concentrate. The memory is very less, very poor, we can say, and the attention span is also very less. So you know, it changes, or it what we can say, it hampers their functioning, like the daily routine. Thoughts of self harm or suicide. Immediate medical attention is required if anything happens, like suicidal ideation, thoughts or action. Anything is there. Causes of depression. No single cause of depression. Maybe like early negative experiences. That might include childhood experience, like you know, such as childhood trauma. School में अगर किसी ने bully कर दिया या फिर किसी ने चिढ़ा दिया, वही continuous होता गया, हर साल होता गया. You know, the child might lose confidence and self-esteem in him, and you know, it will keep on growing, and he might not feel good about himself. यू नो कि बिकॉज बाकी लोग बोल रहे हैं कि मैं कुछ कर नहीं सकता, तो सच्ची में मैं कुछ कर नहीं सकता. एंड इट ऑल्सो माइट हैपन दैट देर इज़ नो फैमिली सपोर्ट, बिकॉज द फैमिली माइट नॉट नो अबाउट दिस थिंग हैपनिंग इन द स्कूल, और द चाइल्ड माइट नॉट टेल द फैमिली कि ऐसे सब कुछ हो रहा है स्कूल में. एंड इट विल इंक्रीज, एंड ड्यूरिंग द स्कूल एज खत्म हो गया, 10th स्टैंडर्ड हो गया, देन डिसीजन ऑफ विच करियर टू गो. मे बी लाइक यू नो अलग फ्रेंड्स जा रहे हैं, परसेंटेज अच्छा आया नहीं आया, उसकी वजह से भी हिल बी लाइक कि नहीं नहीं मेरे को तो इंजीनियरिंग में जाना ही नहीं चाहिए. यू नो बिकॉज ही माइट नॉट फील गुड अबाउट हिमसेल्फ कि मैं ये कर सकता हूँ या फिर ये नहीं कर सकता हूँ. जैसा बाकी लोग कह रहे हैं या ये तुम्हारे लिए अच्छा है, ही माइट गो फॉर दैट इज़ वेल. सम टॉक अबाउट chemical imbalances in the brain, and research also shows certain brain chemical imbalances change in people in a depressed mood. CBT, that is cognitive behavior therapy, suggests that early experiences and life events such as trauma in childhood, early losses, bereavement and bullying. ये अगर सारी चीज़ें होती हैं तो कैसे होता है. CBT also says that शुरुआत में there are like certain belief system that we have. You know, certain rules and regulations that we have followed since our childhood. And आपने अपने childhood में अपने parents को देखा होगा कि you know, there are certain rules and regulations that they have followed. So you look up to them and you follow those rules and regulations. And you don't go beyond that. So कुछ ऐसे हो जाता है कि यही rules है और इसी तरह से follow करना है. It might also get rigid and you might not explore other areas as well. Such experiences, such early traumatic experiences leads us to develop unhealthy negative belief about ourselves, other people and the world. Like I gave example of school, bullying hota hai, you know, log mujhe aisa hi kehte hain. It might also get into picture ki office mein bhi aisa chalta ho, ye to kuch kar hi nahi sakta. You know, that belief is getting stronger that I can't do anything right, or I am a worthless and a useless person, because it started in childhood, and I believe that it has started from that place and that area, age. So, अभी भी वैसे ही चल रहा है ना, तो मुझे तो पता ही है. And he knows it 100% that he can't do anything without thinking about the fact that he has covered, cleared all the exams and done all good stuff. But the thought, the belief is so stronger that he doesn't think that ये negative beliefs की वजह से और ज़्यादा आगे problems हो सकते हैं. The five aspect model of CBT. CBT says CBT is cognitive behavior therapy, which can be explained in the below format. There is a trigger, that's an event. There is thoughts, this is the thought, the feelings, the behavior, and the physiological response. Okay. Trigger would be loss of job. A person lost his job. His thoughts are, I will never find another job. They got rid of me because I am completely useless. The feelings are sad, depressed, and ashamed. The behavior is stay in bed, avoid social outings, avoid telephone. like avoiding social contact, avoiding people, because he thinks that what other people will think about me. Log kya sochenge? Are abhi you might be seeing a lot of people, like, you know, during recession phase, you know, you might have seen kitne zyada cases
people.
Correct. Because you know what other people will say about me. You know, naukri se nikal diya gaya. Log kya sochenge mere bare mein? They feel that I am a worthless person because there was some reason. Because of it, I was, you know, thrown out of the company.
Sometimes a retired person knows that same thing is occurring. I am a useless person.
Correct.
Your team is all retains daily.
Correct.
You will keep him himself ever busy.
Correct. Correct. Retirement, it's also a transition phase, right? Because you are just.
That I'm a useless person.
Correct. Yeah, and a lot of people actually ask you a question: post retirement, kya karne wale ho? You know, a lot of these questions are asked. Like, abhi retire ho gaye, abhi kya karoge aage? But no one accepts that. No one accepts that because, or aise ho jata hai ki if other people of the family are working or are busy in some other ways, that person, retired person, will feel ki abhi main in pe depend ho gaya hu. And you know,
there's comments also going to see, you are retired, so you don't need to go out now. See, you are not that busy. We have to go out in time.
Yeah, a lot of things that happen because that's a transition phase for that person. So it's up to them in what way they are dealing with it. You know, are they still continuing with the schedule or are they sitting and doing nothing about it? So you see, it's a choice, you know, it's their choice, you know, if you want to do it or if you don't want to do it. There's a choice point here comes into the picture. Are you clear with this that, you know, CBT is basically about thoughts, feelings and behavior? What exactly happens if we change our thinking, we change our feeling as well as we change our behavior? So the three of them are interconnected. The cognitive triad of depression, you know, how depression is viewed from CBT point of view. Depression comes in three flavors. It says negative view of self, that I am no good and I am a worthless person. You know, the way you gave an example of a retired person, like, you know, he is no good and, you know, people will...
A lot of times you can stay at home, no problem.
No respect. No respect is given. Any other things for a retired person can you come up with? Like, no respect and, you know, aap toh abhi, aapko aaram hi karna hai, aapko kuch karna nahi hai.
Workload jyada de raha hai.
Sorry?
Ghar mein kya kya work hai na,
miscellaneous work, yeah, correct.
He's accepting that no progress, he's keeping himself busy, that no, never occurs.
Yeah, but there is also think, you know, why this work is given to me, I was much better than... You know, that also comes into picture. The way you said miscellaneous work is given, but I was working on some other big position.
He's feeling that time of years, I was the head of the breadwinner.
Correct.
Now I am the dependent on this.
Correct.
What kind of treatment now
he feels that he no longer is getting the respect which he was getting earlier.
Yeah, that's what. Even a lot of people.
The world is considering me as an unwanted guest.
Yes. Possibility. A lot of people feel that way. And what exactly happens if they post retirement also, if they want to work in that company, but they get a lesser part of job or something like that. So, you know, they also don't want to see that. They also want to see that, you know, they are getting that same position and respect. Because it's like, you know, I was there, now I don't want to, you know, start from scratch and again go up. You know, it's like the minimal paid job as well as, you know, your juniors, the juniors they were there earlier, they are your bosses now. So, you know, that also transition phase comes into picture. So, negative view of self, it says like, I'm no good and I'm worthless person. It a lot of it talks about the self, you know, how you are as a person. Like the early example, like losing of a job, you know, with one incident, the person label ourselves as a whole that I'm totally worthless person and I'm not good at anything, you know. And that is the reason they view themselves like that. The second one is negative view of world. like the world is an unfair place, nothing good happens with me. You might have seen all the Sasbahu sagas. You know, sari cheeze usme yehi hoti ki mere saath hi bura hota hai. You know, zindagi mein har waqt aisa hi hota raha hai. So the world is an unfair place to me. The third is negative view of future. The future is hopeless. Main kuch nahi kar sakta. You know, mere saath har waqt bura hi hota hai. Mere saath aage bhi bura hoga. There is no hope for future. Like, you know, they don't think anything positive about what will exactly happen in future. They'll be like, ki abhi jaise ho raha hai, waise hi hota rahega. Aage bhi waise hi hota rahega. Cognitive distortions in cognitive behavior therapy are basically the thinking pattern and the thinking styles. Yeah, hi. Have a seat. Cognitive distortions are basically in CBT, cognitive behavior therapy, are basically the thinking patterns and thinking styles that we have. We all individual have, but these are specific to depressed people. Like, you know, in what way they think. There are a number of ways in which our thinking style may become distorted when in low mood. Mental filter. The first one is the mental filter. My boss said that I haven't done my report correctly. I'm a useless person. So he is looking at only the one picture that I have done something wrong. So totally I'm a bad person or I'm a useless person. So it is said that you pick out a single negative detail and dwell on it exclusively. Sorry. So that your vision of all the reality becomes darkened, like the drop of the ink that discolors the entire beaker of water. With only one incident, like, you know, someone said something to you, so you are not good at all, you're totally bad. You know, you're filtering out that only negative part.
Blowing it up.
Correct. You're just filtering it out. The second one is overgeneralization. I can never do anything right. No one will ever love me. You will see a single event as a never-ending pattern of defeat. My life is useless. The whole world is bad. I will never succeed. You know, it's like overgeneralizing. Bahut zyada generalize karke, you know, ye I can never do anything right. Har waqt main galat hi kaam karta rehta hu. Mere se to ek bhi kaam theek se nahi hota. Wo bhi agar book ka shelf lagana ho ya bartan manjne ho ya fir bartan properly lagane ho. And second one is no one will ever love me. I'm totally a worthless, unlovable person, we can say. Third one is all or nothing thinking. You see things in black and white categories. If your performance falls short of perfect, you see yourself as a total failure. I failed this test and I am a failure. Can anyone give an example of this one?
The entrance exam we are writing.
Exactly. 10th standard, 12th standard, you know, they might be, if they are short of their percentages, they might get 50 or 60%. I'm not a total failure. I cannot do anything right. I failed this test or failed this exam. Mind reading. You arbitrarily conclude that someone is reacting negatively to you and you don't bother to check this out. The audience is certainly getting bored right now. I feel that the audience is certainly getting bored right now.
But you are not getting depressed now?
No. I'm not feeling anything or I'm not thinking that way. Correct. So, you know, it's like, you know, I'm reading someone's mind, like, you know, I don't know if you're understanding what am I saying, you know, I don't know if you're, you know, what you're thinking about me. You know, you keep on checking, you know, agar ye, huh?
So,
exactly, perfect.
What they have in their mind, and actually they have about the negative picture of ourselves in their mind.
Correct, because they want, it's like, you know, other person should accept me the way I am. If it's not, then it's not a good thing. The next one is emotional reasoning. You assume that your negative emotions necessarily reflect the way things really are. I feel it, therefore it must be true. I feel he doesn't love me. You know, a lot of kids at my not kids, in relationship generally
in
happens.
Gender-based.
It in relationships. Like, you know, I feel he doesn't love me at all because he's talking to someone else. I feel, you know, there is some relation. It might be mind reading, but you know, you know, he's not talking to me, he's busy whole day. I think he doesn't love me. You know, he's not talking to me. What is exactly happening? It's like I feel it, therefore it must be true. You're predicting, you're thinking that, you're feeling that way, it has to be true. If it's not true, then you know all possible mind reading will happen. Catastrophizing. You exaggerate the importance of things such as your goof ups or someone else's achievements, or you inappropriately shrink things until they appear tiny. Your own desirable qualities or the other fellow's imperfections. This is also called the binocular trick. I got only 80% marks. I am not even 1% of what you are. He has everything. You know, you might have come across all of these people, like, you know, 10th standard, 12th standard student, you know, comparisons. You know, I just got 80%. I just now even 95%, if kids get, they're like, I just got 95%. That's it.
Yes.
You know, I was expecting something. Oh, you got some more, you know. I just got, so I'm not up to your par, up to your comparison. I am not even 1% of what you are. You know, he has so many things. Do's and don'ts of being in a depressed mood. What you do, if you are in depressed mood, then what are the things that you need to do? Tell someone how you feel. Get moving, do something active for at least 5 minutes. Treat yourself as you would be a friend. A lot of times what we do is we batter, you know, mere paas aisa hi hai, aisa nahi hai, you know, yehi hona chahiye tha. You might compare yourself with other person, you know, I need these things, or I need to be where my other friend is. Maybe like you're not earning properly. Even if it's 25,000, you want to have 35,000 because your friend is also earning that much money. So, you know, a lot of times you batter yourself. Nahi, nahi, mujhe ye hona hi chahiye. Phir you think negative about yourself.
Yeah.
So, we don't, what I say is we do emotional atyachar on ourselves.
Guilty
bhi hai, bahut zyada. Aur aise hota hai ki we don't treat ourselves good. When it comes to negative part, on the negative side, we are like very much ready and, you know, like on the arms ki, haha, I know all my negative things about me. You know, when it comes to positive part, we are like, we don't know. Because we think a lot about negativity. We don't need to improve. We don't take a chance to improve it, but we still are like, you know, this is negative.
We may have very less number of less negative things. That's why we are always giving importance to negative things.
Prioritizing that. Priority, yeah, that's very true. Examine your thoughts for biases. That is for the cognitive distortions. Remember, your thoughts are not facts. Thoughts are thoughts. It's not a fact. You know, it's an opinion. Opinion and facts. You don't need to do is beat up yourself. That way, treat yourself as you would be a friend of yours. When it comes to get going, you don't stay in your bed. Expect too much from yourself. Listen to the parrot. You know, there is a stat. Yeah. Parrot. It's actually a story wherein the parrot, it's a poisoned parrot. Okay. So, the poisoned parrot is given to you and it's there in your house. And, you know, it keeps on telling you some negative stuff or the other. You know, if you go, if you are running late and if you reach late, he'll be like, oh my God, you again reach late. You are such a useless person. You don't do anything correctly. Right? So, you know, you don't listen to the parrot because, you know, and because he tells you everything, he doesn't know anything. He just sees and he observes and he reacts to it. You know, because he is reacting, you feel, haan, ye jo bol raha hai to wo to sach hi hai. Matlab, I am a total useless person. Because he said, because I couldn't do even small stuff like reaching to my office on time. You know, I couldn't do that. So that is the reason, you know, you're not supposed to listen to.
The person's boss gonna act as like a parrot. Like, right? He always see the negative part of something,
yes.
And then he reacts to that.
Yes, yes, yes. Right. And then you feel guilty about it, guilty and
stuff. Also it happens. Kids, we are telling me you're not done, you're not scored this much. So comparisons happening.
Yeah, it happens. We a lot of time take or consider most of the negative part, because that's the interesting, you know, you can pinpoint and pinch that person, you are doing something wrong or you did not do this correctly, you know. So that is the easiest way to make that person feel sad or guilty about it. That is also a part of it. You were saying something?
So better to say appreciation is a good policy and encouragement is another.
Yes, yes, yes. When it comes to kids, yes, you need to appreciate.
So telling what not to do, you should tell what should be done.
Yes, what needs to be done, rather
that
than...
That is overlooked.
Yes. Yeah, because we generally like, you don't do this, don't do that. With kids, I think we specifically do it. Don't do this, you know, you will get hurt.
Behind the child means what you are isolating himself, just like this.
Correct.
Big restriction.
House is there, just like they're operating like a negative thought also.
Correct.
Every house.
Huh.
Don't do.
Yeah, a lot of times we are like, don't do this, you know. No, never, not. These are the common words that
Mr.
are used.
Mr. No.
Yeah, that can happen. Yeah, a lot of times we do that. I think with kids, with other, even adults for that matter, don't go out late night, you know, don't do this. For girls, you know, nowadays it's not happening, but still there are some places where, you know, you're not allowed, you know, you don't do this, don't do that. You know, a no, not, never is used up all possible times. Research. Studies suggest that 1 in 5 of us will experience depression at some point in our lives. CBT, cognitive behavior therapy, is one of the most frequently used therapy with considerable research supporting its effectiveness and adaptability. Dr. Aaron Beck, you know, he started the father of cognitive therapy, cognitive behavior therapy. His first research was on depression. And he saw that the effectiveness and the adaptability of CBT use in his practice was very effective. You know, he could see the changes in his client. And actually, even I can see changes in my clients during my practice. You know, a lot of when we focus on thoughts, we focus on feelings, we focus on behaviors. If all these three things are channelized, definitely a change in a person is, you know, you can actually see that. Techniques to deal with depression. Get active, behavioral activation. That's like, you know, what do you think that can be? Get active, behavioral activation would be?
The person should keep himself active and busy with something or
another.
Keep himself busy. Otherwise, they start brooding.
Correct. Brooding. Yes, very much. Continuously, so maybe like...
Something. Even sitting in one place doing nothing for half an hour, 45 minutes, the person will get depressed. He should move. Even if there's nothing to do, he should get off from that place, move somewhere, and maybe again come and sit. That movement itself will... enable the person to overcome those thoughts.
Correct. And also we generally see what kind of schedule, when a client comes to us, we see the case history first. We see how their daily schedule is. You know, is it normal? Like, you know, are they just getting up from the bed, having breakfast and going back to work? Again, you know, coming back home, doing nothing, eating their dinner and sleeping. And on weekends, they don't do anything. So we also see what is their daily schedule for the whole week. And what are the, a lot of times we give them two tasks, you know, two new tasks to do it. So they have some change in their activities, like, you know, exercise. But in a realistic way, maybe like twice a week, you can exercise. You start your exercise. Because if we say like, you know, aapko 5 din exercise karna hi padega, to koi karega nahi. Theek hai? To agar humne khud ko bhi kiya, we'll be like, you know, and that is a pretty overwhelming feeling for us as well. You know, 5 din exercise bahut ho jata hai. You know, because if we have not started, when we need to start to practice, we need to start give them a realistic look. So that at least twice or thrice a week they need to exercise. If that is happening, then, you know, they can continue like thrice a week, 4 times a week, 5 times a week. Then they can increase their mobility and the exercise part of it. 5 minute rule, the way you said, you need to do something at least for 5 minutes. Some activity, you know. Get active, it's like, you know, you have a proper schedule and follow it. 5 minutes, you just... what you say, do something for 5 minutes that you have not done in your daily schedule, something for that 5 minutes you enjoy, and then reward yourself that you did something. You got up out of your bed, you cleaned your table, or you did something creatively. That might be painting, a hobby, or something like that. You know, might be photography or going out for 5-10 minutes. For 5 minutes meditation as well, you know. Sitting down and looking back in what, you know, looking or taking few deep breaths and see what exactly you can do later on as well. Challenging negative thinking. Challenging negative thinking is like, you know, there are few questions that we ask in cognitive behavior therapy. The first is like, you know, is my thought helping me in any way? Like, is my thought helping me reaching my goal? You know, that I am thinking. A lot of negative thought would be like, you know, I should achieve this thing in certain period of time. You know, will that person be able to achieve? But, you know, there might be some thoughts or some things hampering him to, you know, not to achieve his goal. So we need to ask them this question, like, is this thought helping me in any way? Or, you know, challenging would be, what if your friend is also in a similar situation? How do you think you might ask them, you know, how do you think you will advise them? You know, how will you tell him to come out of that depression? Or, for example, I would say, recently I've got a client who is an engineering student and he has got a drop. You know, he's not able to clear his exams. So I was asking him, what if your friend is also in a similar situation? How would you tell him to deal with the situation? And he's not able to take out his books and read about it. You know, whenever he takes, he gets anxiety, panic attack, and he feels sad that he's not able to do certain tasks. You know, read that book and, you know, finish his exams and clear his exams. So when we ask a client how, you know, what kind of advice you will, give your friend, at times they will not have an answer, because why would my friend be in the situation? You know, there might be a possibility. They'll be like, you know, mera friend hoga hi kyun aise situation mein. Even if, you know, we ask them, just soch ke dekho ki agar hoga bhi, to what advice? So, you know, we ask them to do that, and they might be like, okay, fine, he has time. He can work on his problems, and he can work on his, you know, make a schedule out of it and read those books and, you know, take over his exams. Then we say, if you can tell him, why can't you apply to yourself? You know, that is the applying part to themselves is a difficult challenge for them. Because they are like, dusro ke liye, because they can advise. But when it comes to them, it's like a difficult thing. It's like, you know, a bit of heavy thing. Kyun karu main? You know, baki ke logo ko bolna bahut aasan ho jata hai. But khud ke liye change karna, it's a difficult task. Balanced alternative to negative thoughts. Alternatives, see, what exactly also we do is, there is a negative thought and we give an alternative thought to that. No, positive. Positive is different. We don't say positive. We say alternative negative thought, because it's a realistic thought. Okay, so we don't say a positive energy or positive thought that we give. There is also no, not, you know, the words like no and not are not used at all, but okay, I will give you an example for that. Can anyone give me a situation? Anyone give me a situation, like regarding to depressed client or something?
Achieve a particular target. You have to sell this much before this particular day.
Salesperson. Assigned a target, okay.
हाँ,
अगर नहीं आता है तो कैसी फीलिंग्स होती हैं?
feel it done in it, whether you've been the job.
Yeah, correct. But how do you feel about this particular situation?
Fear
is there?
Yes.
Yeah, correct. Fear, tensed, and? Insecure.
Insecurity.
There also might be a feeling of sadness. You know, what will exactly happen? Fear to hai, wo to aa hi jayega. What if my future? Haan. Future kya ho sakta hai? Theek hai.
Then after what will happen?
Correct. And what thoughts regarding to this might come up? Will it happen or not? Any other thought that you can think of with regards to this situation?
Is it possible?
Okay, so what exactly happens? Which is more prominent thought that you can think of with regards to this situation? The first or the second one?
He is the only earning member in the family.
Yeah.
He also thinks of the family afterwards.
Huh. What will exactly happen? Correct. So, this thought is actually a question. So what we need to do here is we need to make it into a statement. Okay, there is an answer in this question. Can anyone answer? Yeah, correct. Only two words you need to answer. If it is possible, then you won't have this feeling of fear and sadness.
Difficult to possible. It is difficult.
Very close, a little bit close, you know, just one word you need to include. It's like, you know, it is not possible at all. It is not possible at all. If you think this way, the fear will be there. Okay, so what we do is we challenge this thought. By asking few questions to ourselves, that is this thought helping me reaching my goal? If I think this way, will I be able to reach this goal? Will it happen? If agar yehi baat pe soch, agar yehi soch soch ke dar to badhta hi jayega aur jo sadness aage hone wala hai wo bhi aur badhega. Uski wajah se aapka ye jo kaam hai wo pura hoga ya nahi hoga?
You can ask another question. How is it possible? Same question.
But you can actually change your question also. Like, you know, you can ask this. Sorry?
Possible at all.
See, what that will be an alternative thought that we have. This is the negative thought that we have right now. The alternative thought to this, what alternative thought you can think of? Exactly. उसकी वजह से आपका डर वहीं रहेगा या कम होगा? कम होगा. Exactly. So that is balanced alternative to negative thought. So this is the negative thought and the alternative thought that we are giving what you said right now. At least शुरुआत तो कर लेते हैं, बाकी का बाद में देख लेंगे. उसकी वजह से हमारा थोड़ा बहुत तो डर कम हो जाएगा. Because we are giving an alternative solution to our thought and that's a new thought we are thinking. तो उस तरह से अगर हमने सोचने की कोशिश की तो हमारा ये 2 लाख का जो आपका सेल्स का है वो भी आपको कम लगेगा. Because at least आपने शुरुआत तो कर दी. यू नो वहीं के वहीं रह के आप सोचते नहीं रहेगा कि अरे आगे क्या होगा यू नो कुछ नहीं होगा सोच सोच के सिर्फ वहीं आपकी एनर्जी और ज़्यादा कम हो जाएगी एंड यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू वर्क ऑन योर वर्क दैट हैज़ बीन असाइंड टू यू ओके सो वी नीड टू चैलेंज दिस नेगेटिव थॉट एंड क्रिएट इट इनटू एन अल्टरनेटिव न्यू थॉट एवरीवन क्लियर अबाउट इट allow yourself to be sad there are sometimes you know this actually says that you need to accept it's okay to be sad at that point of time let yourself experience and accept the whole arrays of feelings like you know the acceptance you know it's okay that I am going through this or I am feeling sad at the moment a lot of time even in depression you know they might be like ki ha ha mujhe ho gaya hai but they won't accept it if you accept those feelings you will be able you will be comfortable as well as you can tell others also when you accept certain things you are like ki agar aapne aapki kya kehte hain kamiyon ko accept kar liya how do you feel about it much calmer
we'll be also enjoying
yeah we'll be also enjoying because we know this is sorry
fulfillment of this
Correct. Because when we accept certain things about ourselves, we are much more at a calm and composed space. Okay, fine. You know, let other people think whatever they want to. I know what I am. You know, so we are at a calm and composed state. Cut down on self-criticism. A lot of times we do like, you know, criticize ourselves. I can't do this, you know, I can't be good in a relationship, you know, I have had 3-4 relationships, still I am unlovable, I can't, you know, stick to one relation at a time, you know, self-criticism, continuously criticizing yourself that, you know, you can't do this right, you can't do this good, you can't think good about yourself, you don't look good. A lot of looks, like for women, it's like looks. And I don't look good, you know, my hair is so bad, hers is so good, her figure is so good, she looks good, you know, she's her dressing, her style is good. And a lot of things that way, even for men that way. You know, I am fat or, you know, I'm so short. If a male is shorter, like, you know, 4 feet or something, he might be like, you know, I'm so short, I'm not handsome at all. A lot of time, writing down on sheet of paper is very cathartic. It's like, you know, whatever things are in your mind, when you put it down on a piece of paper, it's very calming down because you're taking and venting out those feelings on that sheet of paper. And whenever you read it out, you might see there is nothing important or to think about those things because we unnecessarily think about unnecessary things. If you give it a try, that will be very helpful. Like, you know, you need to think, you need to just write down whatever comes through your mind, just put it on a sheet of paper and just tear it out. It will be very helpful to you. How cognitive behavior therapy is helping in tackling with depression? You need to ask for help if things are too much to manage. Like, you know, if things are going out of your way, like in your professional life, in your personal life, or in your social life as well. You need to ask for help. You know, asking help, that will be a lot of change in you. Because agar aapne madad hi nahi mangi aur sochte hi rahe, to wahi ke wahi reh jaoge. So asking for help, that is much more important. It helps, CBT helps in making the client understand about his biased thinking, like the cognitive distortions, like the mental filter, overgeneralizing, catastrophizing, and the other areas. Thoughts are thoughts, not facts. A lot of times we think ki hum jo sochte hain wo fact hai aur wo bahut zyada yeah and it is an evidence to ourselves you know aise ki koi law ya fir what you know what happens what goes up why it comes down
gravity
exactly that way we keep hum hamare dimag mein rules and regulations aise hi bana ke rakh jate hain ki hamare soch ye sach hi hain You know, that's not a fact. Okay? So, thoughts are thoughts, not facts. You know, it is like what we say, notary pe ya fir ek principle aise bana ke rakh dete hai humare dimaag mein ki nahi nahi, ye sach hi hai. Aur main aisa hi hu ya fir main aisa hi karta rehta hu. Thinking leads to feeling. If we think differently, then we feel differently. That's the main concept of CBT. Cognitive behavior therapy views thoughts as to reevaluate them rather than think in a positive way. That you said, positive way. You know, we need to reevaluate it. There is an evaluation. So what we do here is, there is an event, there is a thought, and there is a feeling. So what we do, we evaluate this situation, and we evaluate this situation, and we think in a particular way. That is the reason we feel. So if we change our thinking, there is highly likely possibility we change our feeling. We did it right now. You know, we changed our thoughts, our anxiety or our sadness reduced. Okay, so there is a lot goes in here that we need to change our thinking patterns, so our feelings will definitely change. Finding a more realistic, balanced way of viewing and interpreting events. Like, ab ka abhi to shuru kar dete hain, baaki ka baad mein dekh lenge. At least shuruaat to honi chahiye. Us pe hum zyada dhyan dete hain. Uski wajah se hamara hum realistic mode mein chale jaate hain. Rather than, you know, dreaming or daydreaming or thinking ki haan main, you know, 10 din baad shuru kar dunga, uske baad dekh lenge kaise hota hai. To 10 din ka period mein kuch hota nahi hai. Right? So when 10th day comes, again we keep on thinking ki abhi kya karna hai. Exactly. So the cycle goes on, like the procrastination. Okay? Yeah. Where is the video? Yeah, shadow, correct. It's a shadow. So, you know, the black dog is with him, you know, he's eating his head, you know, he's taking all the positive energy in him. He's not enjoying his daily schedule and the daily routine, that part. And you know how the dog is empowered and he has become like a dog because he's not able to do certain and daily tasks that was in his schedule. So it's like a nicely shown picture video about then later on what exactly he does. Then he realizes that he has become sad and he is not actually enjoying his daily schedule, his daily routine that he has been doing for a long period of time. He goes to a psychologist, he seeks therapy, and then the black dog, initially the black dog becomes the bigger like an elephant, and the later part it becomes a very tiny one. He tries to enjoy it, and it also says that he accepts his depression, that he is depressed. So the black dog also becomes smaller because, you know, it's not empowering his life. He's empowering it, okay, and he's, you know, trying to make it more stronger and be stronger in a possible way.